Hello everyone, I am Pavitra Naik. I am studying in B.Ed. first year at KLE Society College of Education, Ankolam. Today I am going to explain about Google Lens, which is well-known feature present in our mobile. Technology play important role in daily need to understand the innovation in technology. We come up with a new feature in that Google Lens is one of it. Let's see about the Google Lens. In Google Developer Conference, CEO Sundar Pichai announced the new technology is called Google Lens. Google Lens is app announced by the Google during the Google Input Output 2017. Designed to bringing up relevant information using visual analysis. Google Lens will attempt to identify the object and show the relevant search and information. The smartphone camera will no longer just see but also help you take action. Lens is also integrated with the Google Photos and Google Assistant apps. Lens used for the operating system is Android and iOS devices. It is the brilliant camera application which can interpret, figure out and communicate with the information within your picture. So, let's see the workflow of Google Lens. Click on the Google Lens icon, place on the object in front of the camera, tap on the shutter button. This will display all the information regarding that object. For example, here look at that picture. Display on the screen. Here the user focus the phone to the chair and click the shutter button. After that, it displays related information about the chair. For example, look at the picture. It includes what materials that chair is made up of and about the cost of the chair, color, dimension about the chair, and also it suggesting e-commerce site for the buyers. Then let's go for some history on the Google Lens. The Google Lens service was similar to Google's, but it was lesser capability. Earlier Google Lens only supporting for latest Samsung smartphones, but after some times it was supported for Google Pixel phones. Because of this, we focus some disadvantage like first one, the main disadvantage, it is not supporting for all kinds of mobile. So later on, they developed a new version. That means, initially this application was built for Samsung Limited series of smartphones. However, other phones cannot use this application until and unless latest version has launched to all other smart users, which includes present smartphones like Realme, Oppo, Vivo, Redmi, etc. Mainly phones which are powered by the Google Android. And second one, by uploading personal photos to the Google Assistant app, it could violate one's privacy. It just to know about the detail of unknown object and few personal photos which are uploaded lead Google to save other personal data, location, access the photos gallery, which is harmful to individual identity. Sometimes the personal photos can be used in a data marketing, which is out of user knowledge. It was too dependent technology. That means the previous version was depending on particular lens specification, iOS and many other features. It was not comparable with older version. It was too depend on technology. And last one, it had lesser capability comparing to Google Lens. Now current system has overcome the disadvantages. First one, current system supporting for every kind of mobiles so that you can get relevant information regarding the desired picture from anywhere. And It will also suggesting some e-commerce site if the users want to buy that product. That means by overcoming existing system disadvantage here, we updated our service which may be supported for every kinds of mobile, so that you can get relevant information regarding this desired picture from anywhere, not only getting desired information about the picture, but also with the privacy policy. So, let's see some advantages on Google Lens. First one, it can help and act as a translator. That means, suppose if you have a picture which is having the Chinese language, it can convert the language from Chinese to English or any other languages so that user can easily get information. And second one, if you are trying to get good photos and there is a chain-like fence, Lens could remove the fence from the photos automatically. And third one, Google Lens can also enhance a photo you took to make it less pixelated and blurry. That means, if we focused on the any images, it blurry out of that around the object and give the detail of requiring images. And the last one, it is fast and convenient. That means comparing to the older version of Google Lens, enhance the feature with high speed and high capability. Finally, nowadays everyone is interested in technology and they adopted themselves for upcoming technology. In that way only, so many people are using Google Photos app by using this technology. We are getting required information regarding to the desired picture. By doing so, we can acquire information even if we didn't have any knowledges, so that it will be helpful to us and useful way. Now I will show the short demo on Google Lens by using Android phones.
Hold on the button. Click on the Google Lens icon. Place the object in front of the camera. Tap on the shutter button to search on Google. After some time, it will give you more information about that product. For example, if you are taking a photo of a flower, it will recognize and tell you what kind of flower it is and give you more information about this flower.
In this way, we can use a Google Lens to find any information about the object without having initial knowledges. Thank you.